Welcome to last part of beginner's Revit course. Let's continue where we left off.
Create a buffered wooden wall in this section to reduce the relationship between the seating area and the road, and to provide privacy. Model in place, generic models, extrusion. Let's create a 10 by 20 centimeters wooden lat. You can rotate this lat as you want with the rotate command. If you want to rotate on an axis, you must press the place key from above after entering the rotate command. Then the first corner you press will be fixed, and the rotation process will start by taking the other corner you press as a reference. Rotate it 30 degrees. Then create a group for this wooden lat that we have drawn. Instead of trying to copy this one by one in a disproportionate way, we will use the array command. After entering the array command, we select the last option and move this lat to where we want to see it last. Then, in the number value section that comes, we enter the number of how many of these will be in this range in total. If we say 10, we will get such an image. Let's say 20. It's too much. Let's say 17. Yes, it was quite enough in the intervals. As you can see, it was a much more efficient and faster method than dealing with it one by one. Now, let's say you want to change the material of these lats or change their sizes. We will not deal with all of them one by one because we have already created a group. Click Edit Group, and as soon as we make the desired changes, then just click Finish. The changes will be applied to all of them. Thanks to this, it will be enough for us to make the changes over one of them, and it will provide convenience. Then we enter the component command for the furnishings. We can add not only what is seen here, but also from the load family section. After selecting the folder that suits you, let's go to the furniture section. There are some furnishings specific to the tables, beds, seating areas, and storage areas that you see. But of course, these are not enough. You need to develop your own furniture library over time. I will help you with this from time to time. You can also access the project file from link in description section after liking the video and subscribing to the channel. After selecting the furniture, we can rotate some of the furniture with the space key before placing them, although not all of them. Place it like this. a table and chairs here. I'm taking the chair as a reference from the plate so that they are exactly opposite each other. Let it be a 6-seater dining table. Let's see what else there is. Place car like this. Put a stylish lighting on the dining table. Adjust it so it's right on top. You can make other changes to the interior design or facade and add something from your own creativity to the project. Add a few seating sets to the terrace area as well. Let's place plants at the end. Set the camera angles now. Let's see how the modern villa we created will look. Once we come to the site plan, we press the arrow key next to the 3D view icon and select the camera. Then we click on the point we want to look at. Drag the mouse towards the direction we want to look into. Include our entire design. And the camera view is now in front of us. You can adjust its boundaries yourself. Then we go to the graphic display options. Select the style to realistic. Remove the checkmark from the show edges box. And set the background as a gradient. Yes, we noticed that the trees are missing, so let's put them in the right away. We do this again using the component command. We can access the camera angles we have adjusted from the 3D view step. And we can even change the name of the file. If you want to change the camera angle, go back to the side plan. Right click on the desired camera angle and click Show Camera. You will then see that camera icons has reappeared. Let's apply the same graphic display options to this visual as well. Set a third camera angle. For example, instead of deleting the objects that are obstacles in our camera angle, we can do hide in view for them. This way, we hide the tree specific to that camera angle. While it is still present in the other plans. Let's hide these as well. Finally, set our last camera angle. Let's take a look at all the camera angles. I took the render frame you saw at the beginning of the video from this camera view that we created. I will show you how I did in minutes using the AI rendering program called Veres in the next video. If you haven't used Veres before, be sure to check out my other videos. You have completed a project from start to finish in Revit and practiced with more than 20 commands. I really appreciate your effort and dedication in this regard. Maybe you completed the project in one go, maybe you had to make a few attempts, but what matters is that you didn't give up and reached your goal. Watching this video all the way through, taking time for your own development, striving and working hard is a great achievement. Don't forget to congratulate yourself. Compared to how you were before watching the video, you are now a more experienced and knowledgeable Revit user. However, remember that it's important to continue practicing to maintain and develop these skills. Do not hesitate to share your comments or questions in the comment sections. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Tech Architect so you don't miss out on one more 3D tutorial videos like this. Let's continue this exciting journey together.